Firefighters are continuing to tackle the blaze on Christchurch's Port Hills. Two evacuation centres are open, with some residents unable to return home. For more on what support central government is providing, our panel of National's Chris Bishop and Labour's Kieran McAnulty are joining me this morning. Morena Cordua, thank you both for being with us this morning. Chris, I'll start with you. How's the government responded to what's happening in the Port Hills?
So Mark Mitchell's down there right now, so the Minister for Emergency Management, local MP's down there, and Brooke Van Welden is down there. So local emergency has been declared, but Fens is managing it, so Brooke Van Welden's down there as well. And Fens have obviously just had that media conference, just keeping people up to date on it. The latest indications are it might go for about 5 days, early indications. Obviously a number of residents affected, no structural loss of any house yet, no loss of life, obviously, thankfully. But it is expected to spread today. We're expected to have winds later in the afternoon. Yeah. So very, very troubling time for people.
Yeah, and obviously they're struggling to contain the fire. You've got two ministers down there. Is there any support that we can expect from the government?
I think the first priority is just to get through and get the fire out, and then, you know, clearly the government stands ready to help if it's required, and we're working closely with the Christchurch councils around that if required, and I think they're focused on that at the moment as well.
Kieran, I want to bring you in here.
He's a former minister of the
yes,
he knows all about it.
So yeah, and I do want to get to that in terms of the learnings potentially from Cyclone Gabrielle, right? Because we looked at that, there was a first year anniversary yesterday. But if we just return to, you know, some of these disasters, natural disasters that we are having. We had the chair of Cyclone Gabrielle Recovery Task Force, Sir Brian Roach, on the program earlier this morning. And he's talking about the fact that we can't rely on government funding. We can't rely on, you know, going back to the government time and time again, when we know that these kinds of disasters, they're only going to continue to happen. So what is the way forward? How do we protect our communities?
He's right in the sense that civil defence is a local matter in New Zealand. It's one of our strengths, but it's also potentially one of our weaknesses. And I'm hoping that the review into both the Auckland floods and Cyclone Gabrielle will give some recommendations around how we can structure civil defence better in this country. Thinking back to Gabrielle, and obviously all our thoughts are with those people because it is 1 year on, there was many restrictions on the ability for the government to get involved in the response, because even when there was a national state of emergency declared, it was still a locally led response. All that declaration did was allow the government to provide additional support, but not actually get too involved in the response itself. Although it is the government that has to front on that. And I think that is something that has to be looked at, because the government does have resources. And if there is a response, I'm not reflecting on Gabrielle here, I'm talking hypothetically, if there is a response that isn't going well, there is actually quite a few restrictions in getting involved and almost influencing how it's going. And I'm thinking back to previous responses, not Gabrielle, where the communication just was not happening.
Yeah.
But the government couldn't take over and communicate what needed to be talked about. So
yeah.
I think hopefully those things come through, is that Mark Mitchell, he's a good guy and he's going to work hard, but ultimately he's the one that will have to front if there's a mistake, even though he doesn't have influence on how that happens.
I don't think that's right. Kieran's exactly right. And look, this stuff isn't particularly political. You know, you just want everyone in the community expects central government to step up when required, and so it's just about how you get that relationship right between central and local government. Clearly some things are local, but you know, central government has a role to play, and then clearly there are much bigger disasters where central government really has a role to play, and so just getting that right is really important. I think Kieran's right.
It is a balance, because I wouldn't want to see the local aspect taken away. That's the strength of our response. No one wants people from Wellington or Auckland coming in and saying what they need to do when they don't know the local roads, they don't know the local communities. But there's also a role that government can play to help those local communities better. Ultimately, it comes down to what priority local government places on civil defence. We've got some local authorities that put massive amount of resources in and they work really well. We've got other councils that are financially strained and simply can't afford it. And if something happens there, they're going to be in trouble. And so that is a weakness that I think that hopefully the whole of Parliament works on moving forward, because it's got to be fixed.
We're going to leave that there, and we do have to wrap this up. So I just thought I'd come back to you guys quickly about some things that you've been doing over the last little bit. But Chris, last night you were at the Halberg Awards.
First Halberg Awards, yeah.
Yeah, how was it? You're Sports Minister, obviously, Sports and Recreation Minister.
I got to present Sportswoman of the Year with Irene van Dyk, who was my I loved netball growing up. I used to watch her every day. It was awesome. And she lived, it's just from the Hut. Well, she was a teacher in the Hut for a long time.
Yes, she was.
That was awesome. So and welcome back, Kieran. It's a shame we're not together because I've got a little present for you, mate. But next time we're Wellington studio, I'll give you a bit of a present.
And how was the honeymoon?
It is a bit lonely, I have to say. Down here by myself.
How was the honeymoon, Kieran?
It was very nice, thank you. Yes, no, it was. We had a lovely time. Thanks very much.
Yeah. Well, it's lovely to have you back with us. Chris Bishop, Kieran McAnulty joining us this morning. Tēnā kōrua.